So the next step, measuring usage, that's the next challenge. You may have several options based on the nature of the service to measure usage. It could be the type of resource providing the support. There may be different levels from relatively inexperienced technicians to more advanced technicians. It could involve the duration of the service. You need to identify the type of measure that can be reliably documented, allows for accurate capture of activities, and meets the need of the user. For instance, you may have a service center that performs an analysis of samples. When setting rates, you could determine whether to charge by test or charge by the hour. Charging by the test may be reasonable if the test is fairly well defined and does not vary significantly from case to case. However, if the length or resources required of that test frequently vary, especially if it's due to factors the user can control or request, it may make sense to charge on an hourly basis. In general, if the service is discretely defined with relatively low variability in execution, it makes sense to charge per test. This is easy both for the customer and the center to track, and it also eliminates variability across center personnel who might be providing the services. If you charge by hour, it better allows for variation in services provided and may also simplify the number of rates that your center is required to maintain. Okay, a few more examples of your options. You could look at either labor or machine hours, count of output, or amount by day. The amount for measuring is based on service or product. At the end of the day, you should be able to clearly support what is being measured, and that it actually captures an accurate representation of the costs incurred. So use whatever unit makes the most sense for tracking and in context. When an auditor comes running, you should be able to say, this is a good approximation for how costs are incurred and is reasonable to charge the users. So now that you know what your service will be, your user demand, how you'll measure, you'll need to understand your total costs. Generally, you want to start with your direct costs, such as personnel and supplies. A detailed understanding of these costs is really important to setting the rates. Next, you should remove unallowable costs, such as marketing, bad debt. Those are common ones. These are unallowable on federal awards and are similarly unallowable in service center environments that charge federal awards. We talked about earlier how this the rules of cost apply to direct charging award as well as a service center. The detail I'm describing underscores the need for good budgets for determining your costs. Unallowable costs are often part of operations, even if they cannot be included in the rate. Without a good detailed budget or an understanding of your expenses, there's a risk that your rate could accidentally include those costs. You may also add in certain types of F&A costs, and that step will depend on the nature of your service center. If we're talking about a specialized service facility, those costs will need to be included or otherwise cannot be recovered elsewhere. Your institution may have its own requirements that also necessitate the space and equipment depreciation be included. This will largely depend on the cost that your institution would otherwise include in its institutional F&A rate. Last, as part of the process, you need to add an adjustment for past gains or losses, especially past gains as these represent over-recovery of costs. Note that some institutions do not allow carry forwards, but that's an institutional decision, not a regulatory one. It's important to understand your costs at a detailed level in order to plan for a future period rate.